It was just a good deed I do, give the old lady there insulin, more than a year now.
That you've been going every day?
Yeah.
She's a 22-year-old college student who attends school near the Caribbean Sea, but every night goes home to the mountains on St. Vincent in the Grenadines. That's where she administered the evening insulin shot to Lily Grant, and where she prefers to stay anonymous behind her good deeds.
The young lady is the only person that has access.
There's no doubt Mewanah Hadaway owes her life to the student. After being locked inside a wooden enclosure in Grant's house for 3.5 months.
I lost track of days.
You lost track of days. Were you able to sleep at night when it was dark?
Sometimes.
Did you know that there was a woman in that room?
No, I did not know.
You didn't know there was a woman locked in the room,
no.
The enclosure?
No.
It is Lily Grant's grandnephew who's now accused of holding Hadaway captive from January 1st to April 15th. It's a pattern of behavior, police say, that Veron Primus had shown with other ex-girlfriends in the United States. Hadaway had dated Primus for 3 months after he arrived back in St. Vincent in 2015.
He was helpful and he was always there.
But Hadaway says Primus carried a 2006 news clip concerning his former middle school classmate from Brooklyn, Chanel Petro Nixon.
I could remember him giving me the article to read about her missing. He said he didn't kill her, but he knew who did.
In late November, Hadaway says she broke up with Primus.
He would threaten me with knives. He made attempts at me 4 times before I made a report.
By New Year's Day, Primus was acting like things were okay. Hadaway said he asked her to come to his house to pick up some things.
When it was time for me to leave, I couldn't leave.
This is the window leading into the wooden enclosure where Mewanah was held for 3.5 months. And when she tried to escape one time and perhaps seek help at the house next door, Primus allegedly caught her and punished her.
Hadaway says Primus dug a grave near the house, took a cell phone video, and showed it to her with a clear message.
And he was going to kill me.
Sexual assaults were incessant, she says. And all that time, Hadaway says Primus was using her cell phone to leave WhatsApp messages, claiming she was traveling to Antigua.
He would be messaging everybody in my account.
Family thought it was odd because Hadaway's mother was dying of bone cancer. She says Primus once let her leave a voicemail for her 4-year-old son.
I just told him that I saw him, went to the beach, and I hope he enjoyed his time.
On April 14th, Mewanah Hadaway says she managed to hatch a third escape plan when Primus had her sitting near the fridge while he was cooking.
He went outside to wash out a pot, and that is when I took the opportunity to put the note in the insulin box.
The insulin box. The college student returned the next day.
I went into it and I saw a note and I started reading. It said that I am here all the time and to get help.
When she opened the refrigerator, did you hear her?
Yeah, I was normally here when she opened the refrigerator.
Was your heart beating?
Yeah.
The college student gave the shot and left the house to get help. Police arrived and ordered Primus to unlock the door.
When he came in to get me, he told me that to tell them my name was Kimberly or he would have killed me.
So is that the name you gave Kimberly?
Yeah.
And just like that, Mewanah Hadaway was set to walk back into captivity, but someone was there to save Mewanah from herself, the college student she had known from primary school.
And she identified me.
She looked in the room?
And she identified me. I was outside at that time.
Okay.
I asked her if that was the young lady, and she said yes. And she started to cry.
All the women associated with this house are traumatized in different ways and frightened to hear of Primus's history with women, including a recent murder charge accusing him of fatally stabbing a real estate woman on St. Vincent.
It could put me to meltdown home when I hear all these things.
And just can't sleep. Find it hard to sleep.
And when you saw your mom for the first time?
Mewanah Hadaway lost her mother to cancer less than 3 weeks after she was freed. And right after Primus was arrested, the NYPD flew to St. Vincent to interview her and others.
Did they ask you about Chanel in Brooklyn?
That was their main thing they were questioning about.
And as Mewanah struggles to feel normal again, she's relying on the comfort of those who know her best, the friends from her village in the mountains of St. Vincent, including the old classmate who found her note. Being a savior is a mixed blessing.
I knew her, and I was sad. I feel good that I did something really great.